glad you had a good Valentine's Day, Creighton. Yeah. Hey, thanks for being part of the drive time.
You have a good day, guys.
570 WNAX, Barky and Sparky, they didn't even get anything for Valentine's Day. Yeah. They got a milk bone today, but he didn't say he gave them anything yesterday. Probably didn't make them a basket or anything either.
Oh, I'm sure that Creighton takes care of Barky and Sparky very well.
I would imagine that he does.
Yeah.
But, you know, I didn't like Valentine's Day when I was in school either.
Yeah.
Oh, it was stressful. It was a stressful day.
Yeah.
Because you made those Valentine boxes, right? And then you handed Valentine cards to all the classmates and stuff. All right, so I had 10 girls in my class and 8 boys in my class for most of the years growing up. We gained an extra girl when we were seniors.
Yes.
So that made 11 girls and 8 boys. And I just got to tell you, of those other 8 boys, 6 of them weren't very good looking. Okay, and so when it came to Valentine's Day.
All right.
That was a lot of pressure, Steve Emming.
Was this something that was voted on by the 11
girls? Well, I was just saying they weren't all that good looking.
Yeah.
And so the ladies would be trying to smooch me all day long.
Wow. Yeah, that pressure.
Man, I'd be like hiding.
Wow.
It's like, here's your card.
No.
And you'd hand it to one of the ladies, and it'd be like, oh, here's yours, Mom. And just try to smack one on you right there.
Isn't it funny how you hated it back then and kind of wish it was back again?
Yeah, now that I think about it, I maybe should have played it differently back in those days. I hadn't really considered it. 570 WNEX, it is the Drive Time Show. We have the coaches show. 2 hours of coaches show.
2 hours worth. The first hour will be football. The second hour will be the basketball coaches.
So we're looking forward to that. Power customers throughout the fruited plain asked to conserve energy for the next 48 hours or so because the power grid could be taxed a little bit. Now, there are new variants of the COVID-19 found in the U.S., so we're working on that. AstraZeneca starting their trials on some children now. Hmm. Starting their COVID-19 trials on children. NBA warns about the flop. All right, here's the flop. Are you ready for this? The King James, that would be LeBron James,
right?
Was being boxed out, blocked out. Now they use the term blocked out. I use the term boxed out in
okay.
my day.
Yeah.
For a rebound when they really didn't make any contact, and he flopped. Already flopped. He huge fell down, and they called a foul on whoever it was. He didn't actually really make contact at all.
Okay.
And now in the review of the play, they didn't change it, of course, and they sent LeBron to the line to shoot 2 free throws, and he got both of them. And in review, they have given him a warning and another player a warning that flopping will not be tolerated in the NBA.
You
get a $5,000 fine for second offense.
Yeah, he was fine. I called him and I said,
"Hey, grow from there."
What's going on? And
you know, the flopping thing always bothers me.
Yeah.
I mean, it's one thing to flop when there's some connection or try to sell the ball a little bit, but when there's no contact at all in the flop.
I kind of started watching some soccer.
Well, see, I tell you, soccer always bothered me, too, because why would they cut down on it? But they don't. And for me, when I was a kid, I used to watch the wrestling.
Yeah.
Right? And then somebody would sneak into the ring and break all the rules, and I always thought as a kid, why don't they review the tape and then find that guy? Or why doesn't that guy ever get in trouble? That's when I realized that
it wasn't real.
Yeah, and so my question about soccer is, since they never review any of that stuff, I always wonder if soccer is real.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, that's my question.
I'll tell you what. Hey, our buddy in Idaho's got another Guinness record.
All right, make it quick, Steve. Make it quick.
Yeah, he and his wife have teamed up for the fastest time to arrange a chess set.
Oh, nice.
34 seconds.
Woo-hoo, that's fast. 570 WNAX is the Drive Time Show.
Your business doesn't stop for cold weather. Neither should your equipment. And Growmark FS knows that performance counts. SureFlow from FS delivers strong cold temperature performance, improved fuel efficiency, and optimum lubricity. They routinely test their winterized fuels to make sure they deliver all of the cold weather performance they promise. It's not the kind of service you'd expect from everyone, but it is the kind of service you can expect from the Growmark FS team in Yankton. Contact them today.
The annual Huffman Ranch Bull Sale is set for Friday, February 19th at noon at the ranch 5 miles north of Thedford. Selling will be more than 350 Hereford, Angus, Sim Angus bulls and registered Hereford heifers, both yearling and coming 2-year-old bulls. Many of the bulls are qualified for use on yearling heifers. Immediately after the sale, stick around for the selling of large groups of commercial replacement heifers. For more information, visit HoffmanRanch.com or call 308-645-2279.
We could talk about some of that, absolutely.
The bull sale is Friday, February 19th at noon at the ranch 5 miles north of Thedford.
It's gone. We had buyers coming out of the woodwork. It's happy trails to that 320 acres we just listed. It went faster than a chocolate ice cream cone on the 4th of July.
When I caught the biggest fish of my life, a 42-pound yellowfin tuna, I was really excited. But you know what?
I didn't this time, but if you'd like in the future, I certainly can for you.
Should just double check. How's everything sound for you, Coach?
Sounds super.
Okay. Turn you down a little bit. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right.
54 acres in Sanborn County. We recently listed. Very fertile ground with good crop production. Has water piped through it so you can use it for cattle, and it has several established tree belts. There are a lot of options with this parcel, located 4.5 miles east and 2 north of Woonsocket. We can help you sell any amount of land,
or we can help you find the land you want, where you want it.
Call Total Auctions and Real Estate in Sioux Falls.
Because of our setup this time,
we don't get aggressive.
Normally, when we go to break,
we get aggressive selling your land.
Breaks going. Whoever said you never have too much of a good thing,
never had a harvest like my last one.
M&S Irrigation knows your extra crop supply deserves the finest American-made way to store it. Conrad American Grain Bins. Conrad American makes America's finest.
I'm not. There's nothing I can say that will end good with this, so I'm just going to say don't. Yes.
605-999-5218 for more.
Well, yeah, I was going to say, look, pretty much every president does, in fairness.
And
I
know
mean,
that from start to finish, M&S Irrigation
you can't really say anything without some
it's
camera
the
catching
all
that
February long at Iverson Auto and Mitchell and Huron.
Jaden, I'm here, and we're all good, bud.
Their lineup of Dodge, awesome. Jeep, and Ram vehicles. Right now, you can take home a 2021 Jeep Cherokee 80th Anniversary Edition with a lease of only $289 a month. This trim style includes eye-catching exterior details and distinctive interior style. Now, through March 1st at Iverson Auto and Mitchell and Huron during the President Day event. Check them out online anytime at iversonauto.com. Stock number 23244, 1289 due at signing, 36-month lease, 10,000 miles per year. Be special on select inventory. See dealer for details. Not all buyers will qualify.
This is WNAX Yankton. Check out the impressive capability of the Ford F-150 at buyfordnow.com. It's 6 o'clock. Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield IMG College. This is the John Stiegelmeier Show, presented by Covey Sports Bar and Grill, a Brookings original, and your Jackrabbit headquarters. Also brought to you in part by First Premier Bank, Premier Bank Card. Believe in possibility. Member FDIC. Sanford Help. Even in uncertain times, we're ready to see you. Learn more at sanfordhelp.org. Bud Light. Whenever there's a Jackrabbit game to watch, there's a Bud Light there. Your local Northland Ford dealers. Visit buyfordnow.com. First Bank and Trust, because everyone should play hard and bank easy. And by Farm Credit Services of America. Call Farm Credit Services of America for your ag financing. Agriculture works here. Now, here is your host, Tyler Merriam.
Hi, friends, and welcome to our season premiere of the John Stiegelmeier Radio Show. I'm Tyler Merriam, along with the head football coach at South Dakota State, John Stiegelmeier, and welcome to our first of a number of shows throughout February, March, April, and hopefully we go all the way into May with our show, which is presented by Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill. Traditionally, we are live at Cubby's with a great group of Jackrabbit fans, but because of the COVID-19 pandemic, we have to adjust a little bit. So we are actually in the West Tower of Dana J. Dykhouse Stadium up on the 6th floor. President Dunn allowed us to take over his suite that he watches all the home football games in, and so that is where we are coming to you. But Cubbies is still a huge part of Jackrabbit Athletics and the presenting sponsor of this show, and this week's special at Cubbies is the Supreme Beef Melt, the thin-sliced roast beef with sautéed mushrooms, onions, and A1 sauce, all with provolone and American cheese. It's served on toasted marble rye. Great to-go options, or you can eat in person at Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill, located on Main Avenue in downtown Brookings. With that, let's talk some Jackrabbit football. And I can't think of a better way to start things than the day after Valentine's to be talking Jackrabbit football. Coach, how are you?
I'm doing super. It's good to be here. It's good to have the season starting. And, you know, I love it when we're able to go to Cubby's, but what a nice place to hold this. Thanks to President Dunn.
Absolutely, and we obviously are socially distanced because of everything going on with the pandemic. I know you and I both get tested frequently because of traveling with teams and of course, the entire team under protocols. In fact, if you're watching, and for those who don't know, we do have a live video stream of our show as well. We have a Jackrabbit basketball show coming up at 7 o'clock as well. For those tuning in that normally hear that at 6 o'clock, that'll be at 7 o'clock the next few weeks. Football going at 6 because you have practice at night. We'll talk about that coming up in a moment, but we do have video. You can find us on our YouTube account. Download the Jackrabbit app in your mobile device today. You can also get access to our video. So we are testing under protocol. The guys are testing. It's just a totally different world from what we're accustomed to.
Yeah, really, since August 7th when the president, and Justin Sell, and myself met with the team, I don't think there's been a normal week, if you can call it. I mean, we have spring ball in the fall. You know, we have fall camp in the spring. But yeah, the testing, Charlie Miller, our medical staff has done a phenomenal job. Matt Maher, in terms of getting things organized, and really that's gone well. And then the university is stepping up and really helping us out.
And again, there are significant testing protocols that must be matched by everybody in the Missouri Valley Football Conference for games to be played. We've already seen that come into play because Western Illinois had some issues causing it to cancel its game at the University of South Dakota for later this week, so we are already down a game, which is frustrating, but at the same time, it's a reminder that we want to do this, but we need to do it the right way, and that's why that game was postponed.
Yeah, and if you followed college basketball now or mm-hmm. football in the fall, there were a number of games that were canceled. I really love what the Missouri Valley did, and when they redid the schedule, they put the bye at the end. And I know there are a lot of coaches didn't like that, but now for the University of South Dakota, they get to play that game, you know, mm-hmm. if things work out. And so, you know, we're going to do what we can. Everybody in our program is going to do what we can. And we'll see if we get to play some games.
We talk about the uniqueness of this time. And with that, for those that are watching can see, we have a little kit here. Coach has brought some of his trinkets along. These are things that the last time we did a radio show down at Cubby's about a year and a half ago, we never would have considered some of these things, yet here they are. Walk us through it.
Yeah, our guys and our coaches wear masks all the time. You know, we're going to wear masks when we travel. Again, John Schaefer's done a phenomenal job of getting that organized.
John is your director of operations.
He is. It's kind of interesting to me because I go in my office and I take my mask off and I get to the doorway and it's like it's you don't even think about it anymore. You put your mask on.
Sure.
And it's a unique world we're living in. So this one of the masks that I have, and then this is our electronic whistle. So instead of blowing a whistle and having that problem with mask, we do this and pitcher's worth a sound is worth a thousand words, and it really, really, really makes practice run smoothly and protects everybody.
And again, we talk about the uniqueness of this year. Playing in the spring is certainly unique, and we say spring, it'll somewhat be winter, somewhat spring. But part of it is the fact that your guys plan for fall football and they arrange their class schedules so you can practice during the daytime. You don't do that when you schedule out classes for the spring semester, and so because of that, it created quite a logistical nightmare for John Schaefer, the director of operations, for you and your staff on when can we get 90 guys together with all these different class schedules.
Yeah, you know, I can't imagine how many schedules I've gone through to try to make these things work weekly. And a case in point, you know, in the spring we practice in the morning. We practice Tuesday, Thursdays. We tell – because our guys are student athletes. I mean, they're serious about academics. So we tell them many times that those class conflicts that might be in the afternoon in the fall, take them in the spring. And so then they flip it, right? So now we have to have – instead of two practices on a Saturday, in the spring. Now we have to have five practices and a game on Saturday. And so I talked to Jenny Seller, academic coordinator, and she said it would be impossible to try to take, it's 104 right now, 104 yeah. guys, and try to get to a afternoon. And so Monday nights we get done at 8:15. Tuesday night's the tough one because that's a long day in football. We get done at 9:20. Wednesday we get done at 9, and then it shortens up a little bit. So I asked Logan Backus, I said, how's this work? He said he pre-makes food at the week, and then he always has some food ready when he gets home because you can't be making food at 9:30, 9:40. So it's working out. The thing that I've learned about our football team, what an unbelievable group of resilient and positive guys, hardworking guys. And it's just been a treat to go through this, walk through this with them.
We've talked about it a lot with AJ and Hendo, and I've talked with other coaches as well. And you and I have chatted a couple of times in various forms, but it's another reminder here is that we talk about the student athletes and what this experience is about. And there are individuals who will go on to play professional football that come through your program, but the majority will not. And this is about life lessons so many times and dealing with things like this and learning how to schedule things out, how to adjust to these things. Granted, we don't plan it for a pandemic, but this is part of the student athlete experience is if you can handle all of this, you can go into the workforce in any job and be successful.
Well, organizing your life in a normal year is tough for a student yeah. athlete. And so this is just exploded for in that concept. And I told our guys, this will be the toughest semester you ever go through. And, you know, the Lord made us. When we go through tough things, we get better, and our guys will be better because of this.
How have the guys handled this in general? Because, of course, there's been so many different things thrown at them. You brought up that meeting way back in August when Justin Sell, President Dunn, and yourself told the team that there would not be a fall season. It would be easy for them to be frustrated about that, and I'm sure they were, but it's all in how you handle adversity, right?
It is, and the leadership of our football team, the seniors, and then the one junior captain we have, Pierre Strong. Those guys have done a tremendous job of saying, believe in the system, accept the situation. That's where the football team goes. I hate to say this, but it's not where I tell them to go. They have to be on my page, but the leadership is what takes the football team, adjusts the football team's attitude. And so that's one of the most amazing things I've experienced is their positive attitude. I mean, you get a new schedule every week. Just about, and as we hone things down, and I've never had anybody say, can we just settle in on one schedule? And we are going to do that pretty soon here because we're going to get into a rhythm. But and so attitude and leadership, phenomenal.
Well, we're going to talk more about just some of the challenges here and how you have to adjust to COVID-19 and the pandemic. We're going to talk about game week as well because in four nights there will be Jackrabbit football in Cedar Falls, Iowa. We want to run through what your lineup will look like, run through the position groups, talk a little about Northern Iowa, and much more. It's all coming up on the John Stiegelmeier Radio Show presented by Cubby Sports Bar and Grill. Stay tuned. You're listening to the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield, IMG College.
Sports Bar and Grill is your sports headquarters. with more than 50 TVs providing the area's best sports viewing environment, including the NFL Sunday Ticket, ESPN College Extra, NHL Center Ice, and other sports packages, plus daily food and drink specials, open to all ages daily at 11 and Saturdays at 10. Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill, a Brookings original in downtown Brookings, and a proud sponsor of the Jacks.
The wait for the holidays is over, America. It's time to make some joy. And we're here to help with the Ford Built for the Holiday sales event. We're offering the best deals of the season across the Ford lineup, so you can road trip with the whole family comfortably in a Ford Expedition. Bring home a tree that's bigger than you ever have with a built Ford Tough F-150. And find new ways to make the holidays bright this year when you visit your local Ford dealer. The joy is up to you, America, so let's get to it. Ford, built for the holidays.
There's a pop quiz for corn growers. Of the top three seed corn brands in the Central Corn Belt, only one is 100% focused on seed corn. U.S. farm family owned and got there without the help of a parent company. Any guesses?
So we set up to do a
little
broadcast.
That's right. With those hybrids, officially making them the grown-up.
Jaden, what's our time? The John Stiegelmeier Radio Show is live, courtesy of Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, your Jackrabbit Game Day headquarters. Over 60 high-definition televisions, award-winning wings, burgers, sandwiches, wraps, salads, you name it. Cubby's on Main Avenue in downtown Brookings. And I popped into a few places here during this pandemic. I've eaten at just a handful of restaurants, obviously, try to be precautious and whatnot. No place takes the precautions that Gus, Jeremy, Stolt, and the crew down there at Cubby's do to ensure that things are as safe as possible if you do go somewhere to eat. But again, great to-go options. They'll even bring steak. If you order Cubby's to-go, you can pull into the alley and call them. They'll bring the food to the back alley just for you.
Not if, when.
When.
Yeah.
When.
That's pretty good service.
It certainly
is. I love Cubby's. They're great supporters.
No, we are so thankful for what they do, not just for SDSU, but just for the whole Brookings community as well. But nevertheless, thanks to Cubby's. And here we are, Coach, again. What a unique time this is. I've had people ask me this. Chris and I were just talking about this earlier. He said, is it going to be weird to call football games in the middle of February? Let me just throw that out to you as a head football coach. Is this going to be weird that on February 19th, you're coaching a football game?
I don't think so. You know, I think it's kind of like a player. You know, when you get into the moment, you have to do your job. And so I'm really looking forward to it. I mean, it's been so long, so many practices that we've had. These guys work so hard. They're so dedicated to the sport. So it's going to be fun, not weird.
This crew, when they go on the road on Friday, will face a Northern Iowa team that'll have a crowd of around 15% capacity. There'll be limited capacity here in Brookings, different levels of limits when you go on the road. But the fans are such a big part of these atmospheres. Usually you go to UNI, you've got 10,000-plus people, and they're shaking keys and they're making noise. Of course, you go to the Fargo Dome, you know what that's all about. The Alaris Center up in Grand Forks is not an easy place to play. Southern Illinois is no cakewalk. Here in Brookings, obviously, it's been one of the best home field advantages. That's going to be an adjustment as well, and yet – am I wrong in thinking it'll be kind of like a home playoff game where that the ones that are here and brave the elements are going to make the most noise?
Yes. Yeah, there's no doubt that whatever percent we put in here, and I think we're going to be blessed to have a good number, those people show up and they will be involved in the game. It won't be the fan that comes once a year because they won't be able to get a ticket. Yeah. And I love those fans that come once a year, but they won't be able to get a ticket. So I think the unique thing, like take you and I, the opener, I mean, there's been sporting events played in front of no fans, all right? So we should appreciate it. They should appreciate it. We only get to take 40 people. We only get 40 fans. So it's going to be unique, but it's, again, we're coaching football. It'll be fun.
And again, for season ticket holders, there will be some information coming out in the next couple of days to your email. Check your inboxes as you'll find out more on how you'll be a part of the upcoming Jackrabbit football season, because again, all the protocols and whatnot. And we've talked about Charlie Miller and Kelsey and the crew with athletic training and what they've been able to do to keep you guys safe, go through testing and whatnot. And you talked about Matt Maher and what he's done. We've discussed Schaaf. But the facilities and operations team led by Jeff Holm, all the logistics, And not just for games, but for practices, for workouts going all the way back to the summer. Every step along the way, there is such a significant process to work through across campus just to make that a reality, and they did a great job.
A phenomenal job. First of all, Jeff Holm is a great leader, a positive leader. Christy Williams is right there with him, and she does a lot of the scheduling of the facilities. Just think about it. You have all our sports in season in the spring when we have bad weather outside. I told Christy, you need to write a book before you resign. She's a tough job. But again, a great job, positive attitudes. One of the most impressive things for me was to be part of shoveling out the stadium, you know, when we had our spring game and all the sports showed up. And it was really, really a cool deal to see the true Jackrabbit family.
What has been the biggest adjustment during practices? Is there much of an adjustment? Does it feel the same when you're working out, getting ready for this game?
Yeah, it does. It feels the same. I think the biggest adjustment is you get your work done, and you might not have a meeting until 5:30, you know, and so it's not like we're coming in at 12. And so it's just a unique time. I've encouraged our coaches to go home and see their families. You know, they're not gonna, the coaches with little kids aren't going to see their kids because they're all going to be asleep by the time we get done with all these practices and games and so on. So just a different time schedule, but our guys, again, make it work. You know, we choose our attitudes. We're choosing a good attitude.
One of the adjustments, too, is how you meet because, of course, traditionally each position group has its own meeting room and they meet with their position coach. Then you guys may get together in bigger groups as well for various things. None of that is done in person right now.
Well, we have moved to that.
Okay.
Tyler, we've adjusted our meeting rooms. We've expanded our meeting rooms. 207 West gets 13 and a half people. I know that because I had to do the math.
But the point is it didn't used to be. Up until recently, everything was over Zoom, right?
Everything was Zoom. Coaches meetings, all we've not had a one total coaches meeting in person. We have coordinator meetings where we have five people in the CCR, which is big enough to have 25. Yeah. And so, as I heard, in Alabama never met in person once. They Zoomed the whole time or whatever mechanism they used.
That worked out for them.
Yeah, it worked out okay. So, you know, you make it work. Our special teams will never meet in person. You know, we're using Club 71 here in the stadium for one of our bigger groups. We're using Coughlin Alumni Lounge area for one of our groups, using the classroom, that meeting room. And so we're making it work. And our guys are resilient. They're positive.
I stop and think back to just 5 years ago and when Coughlin Alumni Stadium was still here and what this would have been like and trying to figure out, because it was hard enough to shoehorn three people into a radio booth at Coughlin Alumni without extra levels and spacing. And just to think about what you would have done in that situation 5 years ago to have all of these things, we talk about how important they are. It's been, I don't think I'm overstating it, a godsend for your program this year.
You know, you use the word blessing. Let's go a little further back. Let's say we don't have our indoor.
Yeah.
You know, and it's been minus 22 degrees. How do you practice? You got to wait for the Fifth Street gym to get opened up for the men's and women's volleyball, adult volleyball. Just the things we've gone through to get it done here. Now we are totally blessed with our facilities.
It's a remarkable step in where we're at and excited to get going here again. And we talk about the Missouri Valley Football Conference, and the Valley is such a powerful league, the best in the FCS. But it did take a hit a couple of weeks ago, Indiana State announcing it would step back and would not play here in the spring. So as you alluded to, the schedule is a little bit different now, which actually I think is a good thing to have that open week at the end of the year. We already talked about that USD Western Illinois game. So 8 straight weeks from the Missouri Valley, but there's no warm-up either. You're jumping right into it here.
Well, we've had a lot of practices. We've had a lot of walkthroughs. We've had, I think, 147 meetings or something and walkthroughs.
Not
and
that
so
we're
on.
Counting here, but.
Well, we wanted a meeting with the parents after this, and I wanted I want to impress upon them how appreciative I am of their giving of their sons up and their sons' efforts. And so that's why I know the math right now. But, Indiana State made a decision, and I've talked to their coach, and he's completely comfortable with it. And other programs have done that, and we've chose to move ahead.
And then I know everybody asked the question about how do you prepare, because this is part of this deal. You have to plan for what happens if someone tests positive. And if it's one person compared to if it's 15 players on your roster, it's two totally different deals. But so do you change up who rooms with whom on the road or who's living with whom? Was there any discussion upon that or how you structure certain meetings or whatnot to try to potentially avoid a situation where one positive test knocks out a huge number of people?
Yeah, well, first of all, we're going to travel with four buses rather than three, and so we'll be socially distanced on the bus. Our meeting rooms on the road are going to be they're going to sit in the same chair every time they're in there. They're going to have a name tag on it. The who they room with is huge. We're not going to put two quarterbacks together because sure. You can lose two of your three quarterbacks that you have on the road. And so we start out with who are roommates, here in town. And those guys are going to get knocked out anyway if one of them gets it. So you can deal with those guys on the bus and in meeting rooms and then the hotel rooms and so on. We're not going to eat another buffet. You know, there's no more buffets, which the fat guys are really disappointed in.
I bet they are.
So, you know, it's all carry out type of stuff. And so there isn't one thing that's normal, but it's good. We had a devotion the other day, Bergie did, and he said, this is a good normal, what we're living right now.
Well, we'll talk about the position groups. We'll break this Jackrabbit football team down a little bit because we are 4 days away from the season opener Friday night at 7 o'clock at the University of Northern Iowa. We'll be back in a moment with the head coach, John Stiegelmeier. I'm Tyler Merriam. This is the John Stiegelmeier Radio Show presented by Cubby Sports Bar and Grill on the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield, IMG College.
Take two parts high-performing hybrids mixed with one part unmatched quality, then finish it off with a secret sauce, superior customer service. Some people may say it's impossible to get the best hybrids from an independent family-owned company, to which we'd say, have your cake and eat it too. And the pilot basically said, well, it's against protocol, but you're right, you screwed up, I'll fly back right now.
Prestigious Learfield IMG College Tractors Cup, honoring college sports excellence across all competitive divisions, both men's and women's sports. Follow along with L Directors Cup on Twitter or online to see which schools will be taking home a first place trophy in June for their season long success. Learfield IMG College Directors Cup, a premier institutional award jointly launched in 1993 by USA Today and NACDA.
The past year, we've taken some things for granted, such as the importance of a consistent food supply chain, gathering in large groups, and the fall football season. Just as SDSU football is innovating to offer spring football games, so too is the ag industry constantly innovating to provide a safe and reliable supply of affordable and healthy food for your family's table. South Dakota Farm Bureau's game plan is to find wins for agriculture by supporting the industry through policy development and advocacy. South Dakota Farm Bureau, proud supporter of SDSU athletics. Go Jacks!
In South Dakota, farming is more than cornfields and combines. It's the small moments and big challenges we all face every day. It's getting up in the morning, taking care of what needs to be done, doing the best you can, and being thankful for the opportunity to do it again tomorrow. This is real. This is life. This is farming. To learn more about farming, visit thisisfarming.org. Brought to you by South Dakota Corn.
Fargo. He's like, I thought they were good.
Know your neighbors. First, so we faced it all right. Real banking.
especially when we lost the video.
Member FDIC, equal housing lender.
30 seconds. What's that, Jaden?
Am I playing the closing billboard of this like the opening billboard of the next one? Or are they just going to run into each other?
You might have like a minute between them.
Okay, that's what I've been kind of told.
Yeah, so whatever you need to do for that minute between.
But I am playing the closing billboard.
Yes, play the closing billboard for this, yes.
Chris, what'd you ask?
The John Stiegelmeier Radio Show continues, presented by Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill. I'm Tyler Merriam, along with the head football coach at South Dakota State, John Stiegelmeier. A reminder, this is the first of 2 hours. It is an action-packed 120 minutes talking Jackrabbit sports throughout the month of February. At 7 o'clock, it'll be the Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show, and normally, Aaron Johnston and Eric Henderson are with us here in the President's Suite of Dana J. Dykhouse Stadium. They will not be this week because it has not exactly been a normal trip, as if anything this particular year is normal, but it certainly has not been. So the women and men, neither one are home yet. We're going to talk to both AJ and Hendo on the phone during this abnormal season, this abnormal week. But that's coming up at 7 o'clock Central Time here on the Jackrabbit Sports Network, and that'll be the run up until the Summit League Tournament. We'll have Coach Stig at 6 and then coaches AJ and Hendo at 7. So here you are whetting the appetite for Jackrabbit Hoops, Coach Stig, with some football talk here.
Yeah. Yeah, right. No comment.
All right, right? So we've discussed how the basketball coaches have changed their attire from suits and ties and more buttoned up to more relaxed in general. Will there be a change on the football coaching staff in any garb?
There won't.
Okay.
The only thing, I normally travel in a suit and tie, and I'm not going to ride the UNI in a suit and tie, so I let the coaches relax. I'll relax on this one. But when we fly or we have a shorter bus trip, I try to dress up a little bit, so. Sidelines, no, will be the same. Tim Lowe, our equipment guy, takes really good care of us, so we'll look good.
Well, let's talk about your football team in particular, and I don't think it is a secret that everybody would like to know about the quarterback position. You've got yourself two individuals who a year ago beat some nationally ranked teams at that position as a starter, and yet you also have a kid outside of Illinois in Gronowski who has really performed well for you. So you have Jabori Gibbs, Keaton Heidi, and Mark Gronowski, and based on what everybody tells me, if you had one of these guys, you'd feel pretty good, and you have all three of them. So what's the quarterback position look like?
Well, it's a battle. It's still a battle. And one of the problems we have is the two older guys that have started and have won some big games missed some practices. And so we're trying to get them caught up, trying to get reps, trying to really literally battle until maybe Wednesday to see who that starter will be.
And if I could interject briefly, it's somewhat ironic all this time with the extra few months because of the pandemic and yet still trying to get these guys caught up because of how much they've missed.
Well, they've missed, but then again, a lot of the stuff we did in the fall and then in January and December, our guys came back in December for 3 weeks. That was all walkthrough stuff.
Yeah.
No pads, no helmets. You know, the strength and conditioning was good, but everything else was mental. And so to be able to get timing and throwing and get your arm in shape and so on, that takes a while. And then you miss 2 weeks because of COVID or tracing or whatever, it just sets you back. And we, you know, we're a team first program. We're going to make the decision that's best for the team. We need to wait a while.
And so you're not going to make that decision till at least Wednesday? Is that what I heard?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay.
Well, and the other thing about Wednesday, that's when we get tested, you know, and so who do we get to put on the bus? And so there's a lot of, again, different things. And I know the press is maybe a little upset about it, but there's nothing I can do about it. I didn't create COVID and I'm not going to battle it. I'm going to do what we can with what we have.
But it's not an overstatement. You are comfortable with any of those three guys.
We are blessed. Yeah, we are blessed with our quarterback situation. They're all different, but they all can win football games in the Missouri Valley and feel comfortable with them. So, yeah, maybe I should use the word spoiled, you know, with a quarterback situation like that.
Well, you're certainly spoiled with a running back like Pierre Strawn Jr., the Little Rock, Arkansas native, an All-American, such a talented kid. And you're not as deep at running back maybe as you'd like to be, but I tell you what, at the top of that group, you don't have anybody better than Pierre Strawn.
Yeah, Pierre's a special player and a guy that may play football after college football. become a great leader, was voted a captain, the only underclassman that's a captain, and he's accepted that really well and done some neat things in that role. But what a talented young man. And the only thing I'm concerned about is he hasn't been tackled but maybe five times because he is so valuable. He wears a different color jersey. And we've done that with a number of guys in practice because we have some depth problems, some concerns and so on. But he's been tackled many times in the past. I think he'll be ready.
The two guys behind him, you've got somebody who is a veteran of the FCS and somebody who's a freshman, and they've really battled it out for that number two spot.
Yeah, Isaiah Davis, our true freshman, big back, we call him, is really a good football player. And again, a mature young man. Whatever stage he's on, it's not too big for him. He's cool. He's really a neat young man. And then Jordan Meacham, a transfer, is a totally different running style than the other two. Very, very quick. Little guy, but very quick, very fast. Done some really good things in our program. Again, he's missed some stuff, but he'll be ready to go come Friday.
Do you envision packages for all three of them starting on Friday?
I don't know about packages, but I expect all three will play. In other words, we'll expect them to know all the plays and be able to run all the plays. Surely, a third and short, it would be Pierre and Isaiah probably more likely than Jordan, but the wide stuff, maybe Jordan more, but they all know the entire offense.
If I would have asked you this question in your first season as head coach in 1997, it would have been how dumb are you? Of course we have multiples of this, but in 2021, this is a legitimate question. Will there be a fullback for the Jackrabbit offense this season?
There will not. No, we've eliminated recruiting fullbacks. We look for two types of tight ends. You know, maybe a little shorter guy that's like a fullback, but we move him around. He can catch the ball, so on. You know, Mike Morgan is the best guy on our football team that represents that right now. So yeah, we're out of the fullback business, and it just made for, you know, a different package, like you say, and it was tougher, really.
You've had some darn good tight ends. I mean, Steve Hyden's going into the Jackrabbit Sports Hall of Fame here, and was officially. Hasn't been inducted yet because of COVID-19, but will be going in. That's been announced already. Of course, Dallas Goddard's name comes to mind, Colin Koshard. I mean, there's a number of others that have come through, Jake Hines being another one. No relation, but Zach Hines is up there as one of them. You've got a very talented group at that position again this year.
Yeah, that's one thing that, it kind of amazes me, the number of good tight ends we have. And we've sold Dallas Goddard a bunch, but we get some good players. And Zach will have a great year. He's a really good football player. Tucker Kraft has had one of the best, I'm going to call it fall camp, one of the best fall camps of anybody in our football team. Blake Coons has had his best preparation for the season. Skylar Cavanaugh is doing a great job. Mike Morgan is doing a really good job. And so we really feel good about that. And let's face it, when we're outside, we may not be lining up with four wide receivers. Yeah. There may be more tight ends on the field.
I am reminded when SDSU first made this foray into Division I and talked about it about 20 years ago, one of the big knocks the naysayers had is that, well, you can't do that. You'll never play a South Dakotan anymore. You'll never recruit a South Dakotan. Every wide receiver on the two deep for Jackrabbit football is a South Dakota native right now. In fact, half of them are from Madison. You just went 45 miles away and brought them up. But talk about your wide receiving core led by the Yonke twins.
Yeah, Jaden and Jackson have had the great fall camps. They, too, have black jerseys on because they're so valuable. A jersey that doesn't allow us to hit them. Mason Leighton, another young man from Madison, has done a great job. Really, the guy that probably has had the best fall camp is Canyon Bauer, who should start for us when we have three wide receivers on the field. But really good players and hard-working guys, unbelievably hard-working guys. And we got some good young guys in there, but you don't get to travel with a ton of guys. So those are the kind of guys that will be playing, the guys I talked about.
It's nice to have two seniors anchoring your offensive line in the form of Wes Genant and Egan Lickus.
Yeah, Wes is a special player. He's a special person. He's a special student athlete. Here's a young man that's going to go to med school. He's going to give that up to play another fall for his football team when we get done with this spring. And then Egan Lickus is just a bulldog in there. He's a hardworking guy. Two really good players. Mason McCormick has had a phenomenal fall and has really become a good football player, along with a lot of our offensive linemen. That group's been beat up a little bit, but again, we have good numbers there, and we'll have five healthy ones to be able to play on Friday.
And that's important, too, Jason Eck's philosophy being that, hey, know every position, because we're not going to play the best guy at right tackle, the best guy at right guard, the best guy at center. We're going to play the five best offensive linemen and figure out, like musical chairs, where they go. In a year like this, that's of uber importance.
It's tremendously important, and that's good anyway, because then a young man learns the offense. He doesn't learn right guard. He doesn't learn left tackle. He learns the offense. He learns concepts rather than play after play after play. Now, I'm going to detour here a little bit. As a teacher, I grew up as a teacher. Mm-hmm. There's different levels of learning, and we really strive to teach our guys at like a third level of learning that you can change things on the run and they get it, because it's not 40 plays memorized in your mind. And Coach Eck does a phenomenal job of that.
Talking about the specialists, Cole Fromm will handle your kicking, both the place kicking and the kickoff duties, right?
He will. Yeah, he's had a good camp, and Ben Dinkle has had a good camp.
Your punter.
As a punter. Jaden Mueller's true freshman is going to be snapping. He's really good, a really good snapper. And then Hunter Dustman may do some kicking too, because he's a kicker and a punter, and he's got a phenomenal leg. It's just we haven't been able to punt live, but two times. We've been outside two times, and those guys have punted. Otherwise, in the S-Jack, you can't – I'm not complaining, but you cannot punt in the S-Jack, because they tell me those lights are really expensive to fix. So,
I have heard that rumor, too. We should touch on Mueller, though. Normally, as a true freshman, he'd be stepping in, and he'd still be wet behind the ears because of the uniqueness of this year. He's got a little more time underneath him, even though he hasn't done it in a game.
Well, you know, in the big time football, in FBS football, they use it. They have early enrollees.
Yes.
Guys come in December. They go through spring ball, and then they're more ready to play
gray
in the
shirts.
Fall. Yes, all our guys have gone through that. And so when I call them true freshmen, they're veterans.
Yes.
In the sense that they've gone through all these practices and so on. And let's make note: Brady Sorensen is taking a semester off to do an internship. He is our starting long snapper. He will be back in the fall. Another phenomenal talent. But Jaden's ready.
Is there anybody who won't play this spring who will in the fall outside of Sorensen?
There's not. No.
Okay. Is there anybody who could play this fall that will play this spring and won't come back?
Preston Tetzlaff is going to go to law school. You know, he's a 4-point pre-law. Got a bright, bright future ahead of him. And again, we've talked about his story about playing behind Rose Boom and waiting his turn. And thank goodness for him we get to play some games in the spring, because what a special young man. He's going to start for us at Mike Linebacker. So he's the only guy. Now, I don't know. You know, we've got 12 guys that said they're committed to come back. Mm-hmm. But who knows? They haven't been through the season. They haven't been through an injury, or they haven't been through something. So, but I expect them to be back.
All right, that's the offense. We talked about some of the specialists as well. We'll look at the SDSU defense when the John Stiegelmeier radio show continues. It's presented by Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill. So come on back to the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield, IMG College.
Let's be real. When it's time to start adulting, teams need a bank account, like a real deal bank account, one that's free and offers some perks.
Yep.
Check out Real Deal Checking from First Bank and Trust. It's free checking with ATM fees.
And we got the basketball show at 7.
Free custom edge debit card and cash rewards when you qualify. You get free mobile banking with all its cool capabilities. And seriously, your personal finance teacher would be so impressed. Real Deal Checking by First Bank and Trust. Real banking, real easy. For full details, visit bankeasy.com.
So I'm just throwing stuff out to you. You're the one doing all the talking.
Spend
I'm just throwing
more
stuff
moments
out.
In the moment, not in pain.
Hey,
with orthopedics and sports medicine.
He's doing all right. I talked to him.
Our team is here to help you overcome joint issues, athletic injuries, and anything else.
Well, I think it was
experience
we ran a game. He didn't
play
when you
need it. Treatment options that go beyond the expected. And a plan that is made just for you. So together, we can find more ways.
He didn't go into work about 6 months.
Learn more.
These fields for eight decades grew deeper roots here. No one thrives here. Bring in world-class genetics and innovative traits like chrome triple stack hybrids and list
incomplete.
Refine it through pure local know-how and expertise. Do all of that, and the only thing left is the right seed. Pogemeyer Hybrids. Learn more at therightseed.com. In South Dakota, farming is more than corn fields and combines. It's the small moments and big challenges we all face every day. is getting up in the morning, taking care of what needs to be done, doing the best you can, and being thankful for the opportunity to do it again tomorrow. This is real. This is life. This is farming. To learn more about farming, visit thisisfarming.org. Brought to you by South Dakota Corn.
Jax, we are proud of you. Prostrallo Auto Mall in Madison is proud to be a strong supporter of SDSU Athletics. We know hard work and determination make for a winning team. So when you buy from Prostrallo's, you will experience our winning team. We will do our very best to find the perfect car or truck and even deliver it to your front door. Find the savings and selection you deserve at Prostrallo Auto Mall in Madison. South Dakota strong for 63 years. Go Jacks!
30 seconds. Do you need new reliable tires to help you get through the harsh winter? The reliable KO2 can be found at WW Tire Service, with technology designed to conquer the harshest terrain on Earth. Starting February 12th, WW Tire is offering a $70 or $50 reward card or virtual account after online submission with the purchase of four new select BF Goodrich passenger or light truck tires. Hurry in and save. This President's Day sale is February 19th. WW Tire, delivering fast and friendly service across eight locations in South Dakota.
The John Stiegelmeier Radio Show continues on this Monday night, presented by Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill. The Jackrabbit football season is four nights away. Friday night, 7 o'clock in the Unidome in Cedar Falls, South Dakota State will take on the University of Northern Iowa. And we talk about the irony of ironies. This will be the fourth game for South Dakota State, of which the last three of the last four have been against UNI. The next to last game of the regular season, the playoff game, and then this one. But it feels like a lifetime ago from when you last played UNI. We'll talk about the Panthers in a moment. But, Coach, we hit on the offense. Defensive guy at heart, of course. Is there a deeper position than that defensive line you have? I mean, I see 8, 9, 10 starters on this defensive line.
Yeah, a number of years ago, we made the commitment to recruit a few more D linemen, and because of that, we have better numbers, and they're a little older. But you're right, great experience. Really excited about the growth Quentin Hicks has made. Should be the starter at one of our defensive ends, and he's a pup in our program, and so really excited, very athletic. But the other guys are veterans: Reese Winkleman, Crockett, Caleb, Stacker. Cade, all those guys are really good football players.
Crockett Krolikowski, of course, had that significant injury a couple of years ago. Wasn't really healthy in the fall of 2019, so we never got to truly see what he was capable of. How is he right now?
He's healthy. Yeah, he's I don't know if he's mentally healthy, because he's a unique guy sometimes.
I'm leaving one to you.
But he would expect me to say that. But yeah, he's up to speed, and again, a really neat young man, a great student athlete.
And we talked about the offensive line and how guys know different positions. At linebacker, that's a similar story with guys like Backus and Tetzlaff, who can move around to different spots, gives you a lot of flexibility at that position.
It does. And again, Coach Rogers teaches them like that. So it's not this position only does this. He teaches concepts. And so guys are able, you're able to get your best three on the field. Now, the Sam Backer's a unique position. Logan Backus is a returning starter, and you're out in space, and you're on a wide receiver a lot of times based on the offenses we face. So we're not going to put some guys out there. You can't do that. That would be murder. I'm not sure if murder is the right word. But Logan will play a lot of football. Logan can play Sam and Will, like you're saying.
Gardner, Lofton, Gales, there's three guys who have played significant snaps for you in the past that lead your cornerback group.
Yeah, they're doing a really good job. Really happy with all of them. You know, the premier guy is Don Gardner, who's a preseason all-conference pick, and rightfully so. And another good leader of that group, and a really good football player. And has made some big plays in Jackrabbit jersey.
He certainly has. What do you think about your safeties? You got Griffin, Norblade, Manchagaya, Stallbird. All four of those guys come to mind at that spot?
Yeah, I think any of those guys could start. Yeah. You know, Manchagaya and Griff have been the starters, but the other two guys have made some really good growth. And Stallberg is new in our program, and you know, again, this extra semester really helped him get ready. And Chase Norblade, again, is one of the most improved guys coming into the season.
will there be anything as far as with some of the differences with COVID-19? Does it really change how things are going to go on the field, how things go on the sidelines, aside from you do have a little more room to work with? The sideline, the coaches and team box has been stretched out some?
Well, yeah. As I understand it, we're supposed to wear our masks. So if you take your helmet off, you have to have a mask on. Okay. Coaches will have their masks on the entire time. The head of the official said, if you try to talk to an official, you don't have a mask on, they're just going to walk away from you. They're not going to engage you. And so that I think would be the biggest difference because of COVID. Obviously, the lack of fans maybe makes it a little different too, but our guys won't be staring around it because there won't be anybody to look at. So
if there is a perk to the schedule, though, the first two games, UNI, UND, you are indoors until March 6th at least.
Yeah, we're indoors, but we're on the road. Yeah. In like you said, a really tough Missouri Valley Football Conference. So, but four of your games are going to be on the road. Doesn't matter. You better be ready to play. And again, Mike Kern at the office, the Missouri Valley Football office, did a great job of, again, changing schedules and getting it so that there wouldn't be an opener that was in a cold environment.
All right. Normally at this time during the Stig Show, we have S Squared, special situations. We've been doing a lot of talking about the upcoming season, but there's always a special situation. So what do we got here?
Well, this is why people tune in.
Of course.
Yes, yes. I've got two of them, and it's from one game in the fall, and I won't use the
names
team.
Will be changed to protect the innocents.
Yes, yes. But this is interesting because these are things we take a lot of pride in, and I was amazed at what happened at the end of the game. So we have the underdog ahead in the football game. They are running what we would call 4-minute offense, which means the old turtle. You know, use as much time as possible, try to get a first down, try to end the game. Well, three times in their series, they snapped the ball with 10 seconds left on the clock, 14 seconds left on the clock, and then when there were 14 seconds, they threw a pass that was incomplete. So all those things. So bad.
That's over a minute.
So if I do that, Justin Sells should be in my office saying, "Stig, I'm serious. You got to be better because all these guys work hard. These fans pay money. This is your job." And but the other thing is, how do you recover a fumble? All right, we call it fetal position. All right, so you don't jump on the ball, you don't pick it up, you jump beside the ball, gather it, and curl your body around it. Twice the same team lost the football to the opponent that beat them. One time it was a bunch of people, and the offensive lineman tried to pick it up and run with it instead of jumping on it. The other time the quarterback jumped on the ball, squirted it out, and the other team got it. What happened? The other team kicked a field goal with 7 seconds left in the game to win the game. So here are four different scenarios that just do one right. And again, I'm not the greatest coach in the world, but we try to practice all this stuff. So in the heat of the moment, you do things that are right. And these are things that happen all the time during the season. There's some things we practice happens once every two seasons, but we're going to be ready for them.
Well, we've got a lot more to get to with the head coach. We'll talk about the matchup with the University of Northern Iowa when the John Stiegelmeier Radio Show continues. It is presented by Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill, and you are locked in to the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield, IMG College.
I wonder if they just didn't reach out and just
of
say,
the
well,
top
hey,
three
you know,
seed corn brands of the Central Corn Belt, only one is 100% focused
us,
on
you know,
seed corn. U.S. farm family owned and got there without the help of a parent company. Any guesses? That's right. Wiffles Hybrids, officially making them the grown-up in the field. Wiffles Hybrids, one thing done right.
To the dedicated team of professionals at Century 21, Krogman & Company. Century 21 is a proud member of Jack's Home Team and is the preferred real estate partner of Jackrabbit Athletics. Check them out today at Century21Brookings.com. Or for more information on Jack's Home Team, visit gojacks.com/home team.
So all three of us are tied at winning percentage.
Prestigious Learfield IMG College Directors Cup, honoring college
sports excellence across all competitive divisions, both men's and women's sports. Follow along with L Directors Cup on Twitter or online to see which schools will be taking home a first place trophy in June for their season long success. Learfield IMG College Directors Cup, a premier institutional award jointly launched in 1993 by USA Today and NACDA.
In South Dakota, farming is more than cornfields and combines. It's the small moments and big challenges we all face every day. It's getting up in the morning, taking care of what needs to be done, doing the best you can, and being thankful for the opportunity to do it again tomorrow. This is real. This is life. This is farming. To learn more about farming, visit thisisfarming.org, brought to you by South Dakota Corn.
Spend more moments in the moment, not in pain, with orthopedics and sports medicine care from Sanford Health. Our team is here to help you overcome joint issues, athletic injuries, and anything else holding you back. Experienced care available when you need it. Treatment options that go beyond the expected, and a plan that is made just for you. So together, we can find your way forward.
Time, Jaden. Thank you.
You'll enjoy nationwide access to care, optional dental, vision, and hearing coverage, and more.
Yes. And then that music bed will take us to 58 and the billboard, and then whatever you got to do to get us to the top of the hour, and then we'll do the basketball one. Cubby Sports Bar and Grill presents the John Stiegelmeier Radio Show, our season premiere, Friday night, 7 o'clock, inside the Unidome. SDSU takes on the University of Northern Iowa. I'm Tyler Merriam. He's head football coach John Stiegelmeier. Let us talk briefly about Mark Farley's team at UNI. And Will McIlvain, we saw him twice there at the end of last season, or a year and a half ago, whatever we want to call it. But for a young kid, similar to a Heidi or a Gibbs, still learning the position, he can cause the defense a lot of problems the way he can move around and also throw it.
Well, he's voted preseason all-conference. Yeah. You know, he's a special player. And I didn't realize this, but he set the freshman yardage record, and then it was broke by the guy from North Dakota State in the playoffs. So he really had a phenomenal year. Of course, they had the playoffs also. But just a runner, a guy that makes good decisions throwing the ball. But he's one of those guys, when you watch him, he just oozes with confidence, and he's going to find a way to put them in a good situation offensively.
And Weston at wide receiver might be the best wideout in the conference right now.
I think he is. Yeah, I think he is. Anybody that averages 24.5 yards a catch, I mean, yeah. He's so long. He's Jake Winicky reinvented. I mean, you just get it close to him, he's going to catch the ball. Very, very good football player. You know, they have two very special guys on offense.
You mentioned those two special guys on offense. Defense, they have one or two in particular as well.
Yeah, their corner, Omar Brown, was voted the freshman of the year All-American on one of the teams, just a dominant type player. And then the guy that I think I'm more concerned with is their nose guard, Jared Brinkman.
Yeah.
He's a heavyweight fighter, and he does it in the trenches. And he just beats you up and mauls you and make play after play after play, and really special players. And, you know, Coach Farley's always put together – a good football team. He lost two phenomenal football players to the NFL type stuff, and he's got a bunch of transfers that are going to play, and there's nothing wrong with that, but he'll put together a good product.
And the other thing, you know, too, I mean, they're going to be fast on the perimeter, and they're going to be physical inside. That's where they make their hay.
Yeah, they're always very fast, and especially their defense is very physical. Their O-line, they're physical also, but they're a good football team. We need to be ready to play, and we've put in a lot of time. I believe we'll be ready.
With playing in the spring and then knowing you have a fall season coming around, do you handle this spring differently than you would a traditional fall season, or is the approach as far as how you use guys and whatnot going to be the same as if this game was being played on September 1?
It's going to be the same, especially on the road when we have 64 players. I think when we're at home, you know, we talked about the number of freshmen that are ready to play. Special teams-wise, I think we'll use more guys. Depending on the score of a game, maybe more guys, you know, and I'm not being arrogant or confident there, but get some guys in maybe a little earlier than you would. I think we're practicing different in terms of contact and so on, so I think that helps. Because it isn't just the football games. It's the accumulated hits that a guy takes that puts him in danger of injuries or concussions or whatever. And our guys, Charlie Miller, again, is phenomenal, and he will call me out, you know, if we're too physical, and rightfully so. He's the athletic trainer.
How excited are you for Friday night?
I'm really excited. I'm really excited because I looked into those guys' eyes August 7th, and the freshmen were wondering what the heck's going on, and the seniors were going, you got to be kidding. Not in the sense that they were being mistreated or whatever, but all the work and all the anticipation. And probably half of them had thought about it potentially happening. But I looked into the seniors' eyes, and then we talked to the seniors and so on, and I'm just excited they get to play. These guys work hard. You know that. I mean, there's football players work hard. There's a lot of time, and then there's 6 seconds to enjoy the game, and then you line up again. And so it's a unique sport, but I'm excited.
Should be a lot of fun this Friday night in Cedar Falls inside the Interdome. Coach, excited to get this season started, and hopefully we can get all these games in and have a deep run.
How excited are you?
I'm geared up and ready to go. It's going to be a lot of fun and trying to juggle everything. It's a unique time. You know, we've talked about it, just trying to make everything happen between all these other sports going on, but we didn't have anything in the fall. So now we got stuff here in the spring. Let's just relish every moment.
We will. You get to see Jill once in a while or
Once in a while. Not going to Tulsa actually paid off this week. What was the Valentine's Day gift for Mrs. Stiegelmeier?
Steak dinner.
Steak dinner. Did you make it or did you order it?
Made it, yeah.
Made it, okay. I'm just asking. I didn't know if you catered it in or.
No, I made it. So it would have been better had I catered it, but it was, got some other trinkets and stuff, but the highlight was the dinner. So.
Well, Stig, happy Valentine's Day belatedly, and good luck on Friday. We'll chat with you then.
Thanks.
Head football coach at South Dakota State, John Stiegelmeier. I'm Tyler Merriam. We invite you to stay tuned. The Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show is coming up in just a moment. We'll talk to head coach Aaron Johnston of the women and Eric Henderson of the men. So stay tuned for that. Remember, the SDSU football team at Northern Iowa kickoff is coming up at 7 p.m. on Friday. Radio coverage starts at 6. We will see you in just a little bit with our Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show. This is the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield IMG College. Thank you.
cell phone. We can do the first segment. The problem is I got to call the coaches, so we'd have to conference them in, I guess.
Walk-ins will not be allowed. Face masks are required and will be provided.
It says I'm connected.
Yep. All right, Jim, hanging up. Yeah, well, we got through it, Jim.
On the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield IMG College. This is the
Chris,
Jack
you good?
Rabbit Basketball Coaches Show, brought to you by.
And it zoomed in on me.
Certain times, we're ready to see you. Sanford Health. Health lives here. Case IH. Step up your game with top-performing Case IH.
Sounds good.
State Farm. When you want the real deal, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Bud Light. Whenever there's a game to watch, there's a Bud Light there. First Bank and Trust. Because everyone should play hard and bank easy. South Dakota Corn. This is Farming. Proud sponsor of the South Dakota Showdown Series. First Premier Bank, Premier Bank Card. Believe in possibility. Member FDIC. Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, a Brookings original and your sports headquarters. Midco SN. This is how we do sports. And by Farm Credit Services of America. Call Farm Credit Services of America for your ag financing. Agriculture works here. Now, this is the Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show. Here is your host, Tyler Merriam.
Hi, friends, and welcome to the Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show. Great to have you with us. First off, a couple of minutes late, we do apologize. We had some technical issues with our flagship. We got all figured out. Jim Remler and the folks down in Yankton at 570 WNAX and Jaden Pearson do an unbelievable job of getting us back on the air as quickly as they did. A huge thank you to you two. I am live inside the President's Suite at Dana J. Dykal Stadium. Normally, I would be joined in person in just a moment by women's basketball coach Aaron Johnston and then men's coach Eric Henderson a little while later. However, the travel to Tulsa was anything but ideal for the men and women over the past few days, so neither team is back in Brookings. The women are en route. The men have stopped along the way and hope to get back tomorrow. Of course, that's because of all of the weather down in the southern part of the United States, really carrying all the way up here to South Dakota. And so because of all of that, we have to adjust things a little bit. So we'll talk to AJ on the phone in just a few minutes, and Hendo will join us via the phone in just a little while as well. The women, nationally ranked, continue their undefeated run through Summit League play with a pair of wins at Oral Roberts. The men fall on Saturday, but rebound for a big win on Sunday in a couple of high-scoring affairs against the Golden Eagles. So that's how the basketball teams have arrived at this point. Both the men and women are scheduled to have challenging road games up in Fargo this week. weekend. In fact, the men right now, based on winning percentage, are one of three teams atop the Summit League. South Dakota and North Dakota State are each 9-3, while the Jacks are 6-2. Of course, SDSU had four games against the bottom two teams in the conference washed away due to COVID-19 protocols. So those three teams are tied in winning percentage. SDSU's already played USD. It'll play North Dakota State twice in Fargo this Friday and Saturday night. While the SDSU women are in first place in the Summit, USD is in second. Its only two losses are to SDSU. Then you have North Dakota State, a much improved Bison team in third place, but NDSU will host SDSU this weekend and then go to Vermilion next weekend to round out the regular year. We'll know a lot more on the women's basketball side of things in the next couple of weeks. Women will play at 5 o'clock Friday and Saturday night. The men at 7:30 Friday and Saturday night. I will be joined by Alex Parker and Scotty Quaz covering Jackrabbit football this weekend. So Brad Peterson will have the SDSU women's games up in Fargo, and Al Bahi will be pinch-hitting to bring you Jackrabbit men's basketball. Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, the proud supporting partner and sponsor of this Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show. And when we come back, we'll be joined on the phone by the head coach of the women's basketball program, Aaron Johnston. So we invite you to stay tuned, and you'll talk women's basketball in just a moment right here on the Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show presented by Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill on the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield IMG College.
Let's be real. You earn. You save. Plan. You protect. If you want to secure your legacy, First Bank and Trust offers savvy financial planning from people who understand where you are and where you want to go. Can help you navigate your options and build for the future, whatever that may be. We're big enough to help you plan for tomorrow and small enough to start with today. First Bank and Trust. Real banking, real easy. Member FDIC, Equal Opportunity Lender.
In South Dakota, farming is more than cornfields and combines. It's the small moments and big challenges we all face every day. It's getting up in the morning, taking care of what needs to be done, doing the best you can, and being thankful for the opportunity to do it again tomorrow. This is real. This is life. This is farming. To learn more about farming, visit thisisfarming.org.
Jaden, everything good?
Brought to you by South Dakota
Corn.
Yeah,
so far so good.
Okay.
Whether you're buying or selling your home, turn to the dedicated
How much time?
Team of professionals at Century 21, Krogman & Company. Century 21 is a proud member of Jack's Home Team and is the preferred real estate partner of Jackrabbit Athletics. Check them out today at century21brookings.com. Or for more information on Jack's Home Team, visit gojacks.com/home team.
Sunday Ticket, ESPN College Extra, NHL Center Ice, and other sports packages. Plus daily food and drink specials. Opens all ages daily at 11 and Saturdays at 10. Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill, a Brookings original in downtown Brookings, and a proud sponsor of the Jacks.
30 seconds.
When the world changes, you change with it. You push through uncertainty by embracing new rhythms and redefining connection. At Sanford Health, we're standing with you at every point along the way, committed to delivering the care you need when you need
15,
it.
15, AJ.
Because even when your world looks different, you can be confident we've taken every step to keep you safe while you're in our care. Call your local clinic or visit sanfordhealth.org to make an appointment.
The Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show continues, presented by Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill. Thanks for having us on this Monday night. I'm Tyler Merriam, and we are joined on the phone line. I believe we have him with us, the head coach of the SDSU women's basketball program, Aaron Johnston. AJ, can you hear me?
Yeah, just getting perfect.
Well, that's wonderful. I appreciate you joining us under these unique times. And I mentioned it briefly, but just to begin things, of course, you're on the phone because trying to deal with the travel issues, of course, coming back from Tulsa, Oklahoma. You've had some unique trials and travel over the years, but this might have been as unique as any you've had, right?
Yeah, this one's been a strange one. First of all, do you have a cardboard cutout of myself and Coach Hendley you can use for the people viewing or not?
I wish we did. We didn't have enough time to prep it, unfortunately, but that would have been ideal.
Yes. Yeah, this trip's been a tough one. You know, everyone's probably been seeing it, but the weather down in the southern states has been just really, really tough. And it's not just that Tulsa area. Obviously, really big storms covered that entire area. So just getting down to Tulsa was really difficult. I don't think we got our team to Tulsa, and it wasn't even the whole team until, you know, Friday night. I think we got to Tulsa about 1:30 in the morning, and that was only about 10 or 11 of us. The other group was not able to come down. They came down on Saturday morning and got to Tulsa about 10 a.m. It turned out when we were going to leave Brookings, our plane had some mechanical problems, so we couldn't take any of our group. We were able to go with some of the men's team, and it was, you know, very kind of them to give us some space. But just getting there was a challenge, and now getting back turned out to be even more difficult. We were lucky that we left, you know, this morning before really some more bad weather hit, and I think that covers it, went back a little bit. So this has been a tough one, long one, but, you know, we're making the most of it. It's still a good time together and something the team will certainly remember.
Well, certainly first and foremost, the health and safety of everybody involved is what needs to be taken care of. And so to make sure that you guys could get to Tulsa, even though it was in two different pieces, to get there in one piece was huge. And the other thing, too, and we've talked about this, there probably aren't a lot of schools that would have had that cooperation between its men's and women's basketball programs that Coach Henderson and you did to be able to figure out a way to get as many people to Tulsa at one time as possible.
Yeah, I just think that's always, you know, been the case at South Dakota State. Coach Hendo is just a great, great person. Anyone that knows him, I think, would, you know, easily see that in the first few seconds of interacting with him. He's just such a good guy. And, yeah, there's always been a good cooperation there, and I think there has been since I've been at South Dakota State with all the other teams. So, yeah, good family, and then definitely without that, I don't know that our team would have gotten down there to be able to even play on Saturday, to be honest with you. I'm sure that game would have been either canceled or pushed back. It just wouldn't have happened. So, yeah, really lucky that it worked out that way.
When you go through things like this, where, again, the team's kind of split up and you've got unique travel, I would think it's very important to keep things a little more lighthearted and to make sure that even though there may be some stress behind the scenes for the likes of you and your staff and Kristen Roeder, the director of operations, so the team, the players themselves, don't sweat any of the things that are going on.
Yeah, you have to try and keep things light, and I think perspective is also really important in those things, and we talk a lot about it. This is challenging. There's no doubt, and you hope it doesn't have a couple of days of a lag time, you know, to kind of hold us back as we get going forward. But it's also not the hardest thing any of us will ever have to deal with. You know, it's a distraction and it makes things more difficult, but it didn't prevent us from playing the game. You know, it didn't prevent us from having an opportunity to play and accomplish our goals. And I think for us, that's kind of how we looked at it, as an opportunity. Sometimes you get opportunities that come your way out of positive, sometimes out of a little adversity, and what you do with that really ends up kind of defining, you know, the kind of people and kind of team that you have. And for us, I thought we really handled the adversity piece really well.
Well, let's talk about the game on Saturday. It's an 82-60 win, but there's so much more to it. Again, maybe somewhat understandable considering the circumstances, a bit of a slow start. I think you only made one of your first 16 shots. You end the first quarter 3 out of 19. But my goodness, what a second quarter. Made all 11 of your shots, hit 7 of 7 from 3, and you take a 3-point deficit at the end of the first quarter and turn it around to a 43-27 halftime edge.
Yeah, and I don't mean to interrupt. I'll talk about that. I don't know if you can hear my phone beeping. My youngest daughter now has a messenger. She's trying to jump into our call right here, not quite understanding that Dad's on the radio live, so I apologize if you guys are hearing.
Let her jump in. The more the merrier, AJ.
I'm not sure that would be a good time. But, yeah, the first first quarter was, I just thought we were a little bit sluggish, and I don't doubt it had something to do with just kind of the logistics, but, you know, we missed some good shots, I thought, in the first few minutes. We didn't quite have our legs under us, I didn't think. We weren't really playing with the kind of pace we needed to. But I thought we played hard. That wasn't the issue at all, but just didn't really settle into an offensive rhythm. And then that second quarter was just, you know, played as well as we could. Sidney Stapleton making threes for us. Maddie made three for us. You know, everybody in that second quarter just played fantastic. I think we were 11-11 from the field and just maybe one free throw, and that was, you know, a huge difference in that game. That really created some separation. The second half, I thought we played well, too, but that second quarter was as good as we can play offensively.
And defensively, you know, Kenny Joe Lippi ends up with 16 points, one of the better players for ORU. But inside, Reagan Shoemaker's one of the best ORU has to offer, and you completely neutralized her as far as her ability to score at the rim on Saturday.
Yeah, no doubt. We really did. And I thought Kate did a nice job on her. Having Callie back adds just another interior presence for us. Kate and Mace have done a fantastic job, but Callie is really a good defensive, you know, forward post-type player. She can rebound really well, uses her position and footwork really well to get other people off the block. I think Peyton's doing a great job in there, too. But that group of all three of them, I think, really made it difficult for her to get as comfortable. She just didn't get many touches. I think Paul Roberts really became perimeter-orientated. And on Saturday, that worked to our advantage. You know, they weren't shooting the ball from the perimeter as well as maybe they needed you to stay in that game. But you're right, I thought we kind of made them somewhat one-dimensional with a lot of dribble penetration and a lot of jump shots.
We've talked about her, but an example again on Saturday, just how good Madison Velastin is already, and she's still learning the college game.
Yeah, she played great. She made some shots. She had a driving basket for us. You know, I just think she's really gotten comfortable with what we're doing. And if people watch us play right now because of, say, Maya and Tylee in particular, Pete as well, we're getting so many points and so much penetration and just things going to the basket. Maddie and Sydney, their ability to make shots off the bench has really spread the floor. And Maddie has certainly stepped into that role as kind of that knockdown shooter. And she'll do other things for us too. She's good in the post. She's good off the dribble. But obviously her biggest, you know, jump that she's made probably since Christmas is just that consistency from the three-point line. And that's great to see her do that, because I think in November and December she was just trying to get comfortable and maybe wasn't quite there yet. She was taking a good shot, but just didn't see the ball go in the net very much. And now since we've come back from Christmas, it's almost to the point where you feel like when she shoots it, it's going to go in, and she starts to believe that too. So, you know, doing that is great for her, but that really changes, I think, how teams have to look at us with some of our other players who are really doing a lot of damage going to the basket.
Again, for those just tuning in, I'm Tyler Merriam. Aaron Johnston joining us on the bus headed north. Travel issues caused both he and Eric Henderson's teams to not be back in Brookings after their trip to Tulsa. So we're making the best of this, and AJ's on the phone on the bus, and we appreciate him being willing to join us. AJ, we talked about Saturday's game. Now let's turn to Sunday. And at the half, you lead 38-32. ORU had a great start to that third period. Then you had a better finish to it and had to grind this out down the stretch. And an impressive sign for your team to be able to find a way to pull out a close game on the road.
Yeah, no, absolutely. I really thought we played well on Saturday and Sunday. I think the difference was Paul Roberts made more shots on Sunday, and that's the only difference. And they played very well. They're a very good team. They have a lot of young players. I think as they continue to develop, that's going to be a scary team, not only in the next few years, but even each week from watching them and then seeing them play against us. They're just more and more confident. You know, but going into, I think at the end of the third quarter, so at the beginning of the fourth, they were 10-20 from the three-point line.
Yeah.
And anytime you go 10-20 at home, you're probably going to win that game. And so I think that says a lot about our team, just how well we continued to play, that we were able to overcome that. I think anyone that followed the weekends, you know, can see Tylee just had one of those weekends where she just had a tough time. It just didn't go the way that we've seen Tylee play, I think, all winter. And another good example of most teams in that situation, if you take one of your best players kind of out of the equation and the other team shoots it as well as they do, again, that's a big mountain to overcome, but I thought our team handled it really well. We even got down, I think, by a bucket or two there, and just responded, you know. And Maya was special. We haven't talked about her yet, and it almost becomes expected. I mean, she was fantastic, and I know earned another Summit League Player of the Week award. But 30 points, and I don't want to say it was a quiet 30 because it never is, but she just is so efficient in what she does. Some of her passes when she got low into the basket where she had two or three people on her to be able to see shooters on the other side, you know, that's pretty amazing. I mean, very few people have the ability to do that. So, you know, she was absolutely a huge part of that Sunday win, and she, you know, really helped us go. But Peyton was very good in that game, too. Sydney made shots, and other people stepped up. So, you know, despite us having some things that maybe didn't go our way, and Oral Roberts playing as well as they did, yeah, an absolutely great sign that our team is able to hang in there and play with poise and composure. And the last 3-4 minutes of that game, we were outstanding, and that's what really sealed that win for us.
To highlight Selland again, 30 points, 8 rebounds, and 6 assists. She earned her 6th Summit League Player of the Week award. She was also named Madness's National Mid-Major Player of the Week, so quite an honor for the Letcher native. But one other thing that stood out to me, AJ, was the aggressiveness defensively. You blocked 7 shots in the game, which matches a season high, yet you did it within the rule book because you only sent Oral Roberts to the free throw line 5 times. Sometimes it's easy to be aggressive but commit a lot of fouls. I thought you were aggressive and yet didn't foul a whole lot in that game.
Yeah, we were really, you know, concerned about that part of it because Oral Roberts is really explosive to the basket, and when they play well, they usually get to the free throw line. Free throw line is always a good indicator of how teams are going to do. That's why it's so important to us offensively to get there. And I think the first night they maybe had 15 more attempts than they did. The second night, I think they had maybe 10 more attempts than they did. It's just a huge part of the game. And keeping them off the foul line, I thought, was critical. Because it not only is just points, but it also changes how we can defend. If we can be really aggressive and keep our, you know, core group out there and not have to worry about foul trouble for them, that's a huge advantage for us. So, yeah, blocking the shots was really important. Just our way of disrupting them and forcing some turnovers. Some of those threes in that Saturday afternoon second quarter where we really shot it well, a lot of those threes came in transition after great defensive stops and getting out and going. And I would say even on, you know, Sunday when we created a little bit of space there in the throughout the game, but even late, a couple of those plays were transition plays, resulting in really good defense. So, yeah, I was really pleased with that part of it. It's great to see Haley make shots again. I think she's getting her confidence back and playing at the level she played at before Christmas. We just had a lot of people, I think, move forward in what I think is always a tough place to play against a good team.
Well, the SDSU women win 2 this weekend in Tulsa, 82-60 on Saturday, 73-61 on Sunday against Oral Roberts. They are scheduled to be at North Dakota State on Friday and Saturday. We'll talk about that on the phone with head coach Aaron Johnston of the SDSU women when our Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show continues, presented by Cubby Sports Bar and Grill on the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield IMG College.
First Bank and Trust. Real banking, real easy. Equal opportunity lender.
In South Dakota, farming is more than cornfields and combines. It's the small moments and big challenges we all face every day. It's getting up in the morning, taking care of what needs to be done, doing the best you can, and being thankful for the opportunity to do it again tomorrow. This is real. This is life. This is farming. Visit thisisfarming.org. Brought to you by South Dakota Corn.
In the truck game, greatness is defined by a relentless commitment to the customer, forged over decades and built by a team resolute in helping you achieve your greatness. Experience the all-new 2021 Ford F-150 and Ford Super Duty for a performance like no other. Ford F-Series, America's best-selling truck for 44 years straight. Based on 1977 to 2020 calendar year total sales.
When the world changes, you change with it. You push through uncertainty by embracing new rhythms and redefining connection. At Sanford Health, we're standing with you at every point along the way. committed to delivering the care you need when you need it. Because even when your world looks different, you can be confident we've taken every step to keep you safe while you're in our care. Call your local clinic or visit sanfordhealth.org to make an appointment.
It's back, the return of the prestigious Learfield IMG College Directors Cup, honoring college sports excellence across all competitive divisions, both men's and women's sports.
Jaden, where are we at?
Along with L Directors Cup on Twitter or online.
A minute 40.
Schools will be taking home a first place trophy in June for their season-long success. Learfield IMG College Directors Cup, a premier institutional award jointly launched in 1993 by USA Today and NACDA.
Cubby Sports Bar and Grill is your sports headquarters, with more than 50 TVs providing the area's best sports viewing environment, including the NFL Sunday Ticket, ESPN College Extra, NHL Center Ice, and other sports packages.
Oh, yeah,
plus daily food and drink specials, open to all ages daily at 11 and Saturdays at 10. Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, a Brookings original in downtown Brookings, and a proud sponsor of the Jacks.
Take the crown. Visit Royal River Casino and Hotel in Flandreau.
All right, 30 seconds here, AJ. I've got you potted down, so I can't hear you, but I've got 30 seconds, and then we'll get you going.
Cadet snow thrower and earn entries to win a new Kawasaki Mule with winch and blade on February 27th. Plus, cook with class every Wednesday from 8 to 8. Earn 100 points on your Royal Rewards card and receive your kitchen essential. First come, first serve. Collect all four. Royal River Casino Hotel. Must be 21.
30 seconds.
What's different about LG Seeds? You get a team of real people focused on real results for your entire operation. While other companies say teamwork, LG Seeds lives it. From lab to field, we're there every step of the way to help you find your next advantage. Pair that with your drive, and it all comes down to this. Divide the tasks, multiply the results. Get down to business at lgseeds.com.
Cubby Sports Bar and Grill presents the Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show. And, of course, Cubby's on Main Avenue in downtown Brookings, your Jackrabbit game day headquarters. All these events, men's and women's basketball, football, on the road this weekend. And you can watch them down at Cubby's great to-go options as well. Check them out, CubbySportsBarAndGrill.com or Cubby's on Main Avenue in downtown Brookings, your Jackrabbit game day headquarters and the presenting sponsor of the Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show. I'm Tyler Merriam in Brookings, inside the President's Suite of Dana J. Dykal Stadium. The SDSU women had some issues with their travel, as did the Jackrabbit men, but kind enough to join us on the phone, the head coach of the SDSU women, Aaron Johnston, to talk about his program and where things are at on the drive along. And, Coach, again, thanks for joining us on this trip. And first and foremost, the fact that you guys will get home tonight with the short week playing in Fargo on Friday, that's a big deal.
Yeah, I think it is. It's not just getting home and getting everyone back in their own environment and just getting back to practice. We'll take tomorrow off, you know, we'll take a little more time. So, you know, it's not just getting in the gym, but you know, we all have, not just us, but every team this time of year. You've got players that are just kind of banged up and, you know, probably need some time in the training room and they're missing out on that. Obviously, we were lucky today that there weren't, you know, classes, so we had a little bit of a break there, but they're going to have to jump right back into classes tomorrow. We've got couple that have big tests coming up tomorrow, and you know their study environments, but in a bus here for 11 hours, which you know is challenging too. So for a lot of reasons, it's just really important to get everybody home, I think, and certainly the games coming up are a big part of that too. But there's just a lot going on, and it'll be nice to get back into Brookings. We're not quite ready to see the lights over these last couple of hills, but we're getting there.
Maybe it's not exactly the right phrase to use, but watching Peyton Burkhart and the way she's played lately just seems like she's really comfortable in her own skin right now.
Yeah, I think comfortable in her role, comfortable with how teams are playing her. We've been able to use her differently this year, which I think has really helped her. Last year, we put a lot of pressure on Peyton to be a playmaker at the basket. You know, we needed that in that year's team, and she did a fantastic job of it. But really, Peyton's strengths are more moving and versatile, inside, outside. She's a great passer. She can just do so much more. And last year's team kind of required a certain plan, and she was great about, you know, really filling that role. But this year, we're just able to use her in so many different ways, which changes how teams have to play us. But to see her make shots on the perimeter, and it's not just three. She's good in the mid-range game, too. She's each game, there's a couple of times where she's putting it on the floor and getting to the basket. It just takes a lot of pressure off of her to be able to do those other things. And I think, quite honestly, you know, she's one of those, I don't want to say quiet stories of this year, because she's not quiet, I think, in our opinion, in our fans' opinion. Maya's having such a good year. It's just so easy for people to focus on her. But I'm, you know, without Peyton playing the way she has, or Tylee playing the way she has, or some other people, you know, Maya's not having the year that she would be able to have. So, yeah, Peyton's a huge part of what we do. And we just really like how, as you said, comfortable she looks. And really the level that she's playing at is certainly as good as she was in the past, and probably better because she's been able to expand other parts of her game.
North Dakota State is a vastly improved basketball team, 14-4 on the year, in third place at 9-3. Now the Bison will be tested here the last two weekends, playing numbers 1 and 2 in the league, with SDSU and USD their last two opponents in conference play. So you head to Fargo this weekend to see NDSU. I don't know how much you've had a chance to dig into them because of the issues here with the travel, that of course playing on Saturday and Sunday, but what do you make of this improved North Dakota State team?
Yeah, well, we've seen them a lot, and we're getting kind of some thoughts in place. They're just a really good, balanced team. Inside, they've got a great post player who can score at their back to the basket. She's also a great passer, so if you try and, you know, double or really put a lot of help in there, she can pick you apart. Then on the perimeter, they've got a lot of players that can make shots, a lot of players that can put the ball on the floor. I'd say really balanced offensive plan, where you can't just lock into any one or two things, and just really, I think, complete team offensively. And then defensively, just physical. I mean, they really keep you away from the basket. So, you know, there's a reason they're playing well. There's a reason their record is what it is. They haven't, you know, backed their way into that. They've been outstanding, I think, really all year. They've had to overcome some injuries, you know, which is always difficult. But they've kind of found their stride here again since the kind of midway point of the conference season, and played really well. So, you know, all these games coming down the stretch are always important, and it just kind of worked out where a lot of these, you know, teams in the top, you know, half of the conference are all going to end up playing each other now, and it'll be interesting to see how it all shakes out. But this is going to be a really tough road trip after what we thought was already a tough road trip. Now getting ready to head up to Fargo for a rivalry game on top of that, too. So, yeah, it'll be fun, but it'll be a big challenge for us.
Friday and Saturday, 5 o'clock each night up in the Shield Center. The Jackrabbit women taking on North Dakota State. Coach, can't thank you enough for the time. Appreciate you working through this unique travel circumstance with us. Get home safe, and we'll see you back here next week.
Okay, thank you.
That's Aaron Johnston, the head coach of the SDSU women's basketball team. When we come back, we'll get the head coach of the men on the phone. Eric Henderson joins us in just a moment. You are listening to the Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show, presented by Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill. This is the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield, IMG College.
Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill is your sports headquarters, with more than 50 TVs providing the area's best sports viewing environment, including the NFL Sunday Ticket, ESPN College Extra, NHL Center Ice, and other sports packages. Plus daily food and drink specials. Open to all ages daily at 11 and Saturdays at 10. Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill, a Brookings original in downtown Brookings, and a proud sponsor of the Jacks.
Let's be real. You dream it. You start it. You build it. You grow it. That's what makes this such a great... Equal opportunity lender.
In the truck game, greatness is defined by a relentless commitment to the customer, forged over decades and built by a team resolute in helping you achieve your greatness. Experience the all-new 2021 Ford F-150 and Ford Super Duty for a performance like no other. Ford F-Series, America's best-selling truck for 44 years straight and counting. Based on 1977 to 2020 calendar year total sales.
In South Dakota, farming is more than cornfields and combines. It's the small moments and big challenges we all face every day.
It's getting up in the morning, taking care of what needs to be done, doing the best you can, and being thankful for the opportunity to do it again tomorrow. This is real. This is life. This is farming. To learn more about farming, visit thisisfarming.org. Brought to you by South Dakota Corn.
Whether you're buying or selling your home, turn to the dedicated team of professionals at Century 21, Krogman & Company. Century 21 is a proud member of Jack's Home Team and is the preferred real estate partner of Jackrabbit Athletics. Check them out today at century21brookings.com. Or for more information on Jack's Home Team, visit gojacks.com/home team.
Seconds.
When the world changes, you change with it. You push through uncertainty by embracing new rhythms and redefining connection. At Sanford Health, we're standing with
Jaden, time, please.
15 seconds.
Thank you.
Committed to delivering the care you need when you need
10
it.
Seconds, I know.
Because even when your world looks different, you can be confident we've taken every step to keep you safe while you're in our care. Call your local clinic or visit sanfordhealth.org to make an appointment.
The Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show continues on this Monday night. I'm Tyler Merriam. Great to have you with us. Show is presented by our friends at Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill. Cubby's, located on Main Avenue in downtown Brookings. We invite you to try this week's feature. It is the Supreme Beef Melt. It's thin-sliced roast beef with sautéed mushrooms, onions, A1 sauce, provolone, and American cheese, and it's all served on a toasted marble rye. Be sure to check it out. Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill, Main Avenue, right here in downtown Brookings. Great to have you with us. I am inside the West Tower of Dana J. Dykhouse Stadium, normally joined here in the President's Suite in person by the head coach of the SDSU men. That's Eric Henderson. But instead, we go to the phone line to hear from Coach Hendo. AJ, in his travel, the Jackrabbit women were on the bus. They had just gotten past Sioux City, and they were on I-29 when we talked to him. Hendo, good evening, and where might you be this evening?
Well, unfortunately, I'm sitting in a hotel room in Joplin, Missouri. We had a little different route going back, and the roads, I think, were a little tougher for us. And it, something where safety's first, my man, and we decided to shut her down and get home tomorrow.
Well, again, safety certainly comes first, and we talked about it with AJ too, but the uniqueness of the circumstances of probably at a lot of schools going through what the women's basketball team did, the men might have said, well, you're on your own, you figure it out, and instead you found a way to allow AJ to at least get many members of his team and his program to Tulsa within 12 hours of tip-off. Not everybody would have done that, and you guys found a way to work together to make the best of a bad situation on Friday night.
Well, it comes from the top, as you're well aware. It's our whole athletic department is a family, and Justin portrays that himself and as our athletic director, and you know, it just kind of spreads throughout the whole department, and they're good people, and we kind of have the same objectives, and we're looking to accomplish the same things, and so when you can help out, you help out.
Let's talk about your two games in Tulsa against Oral Roberts. If you never hear the name Max Asmus again, would you be all right with that?
Well, he's a challenge. I'll be honest, it's fun to prepare for a guy like that, though. It's fun to play against good players, and you know, he's a tiny little guy, but he is so dynamic, and you know, he is in unlimited range. You know, it almost feels like you're playing against a Steph Curry-esque, you know, for our league, and he's fun to play against, but he's also a big challenge as well.
Obviously, it was great. 42 points, Asmus was, but O'Banner hits three threes. Juergens hits three threes. Stevens hits three threes. It was those guys, and not that O'Banner's chopped liver. I mean, he's averaging a double-double on the year and had one on that particular Saturday, but it was the other guys in the 16-for-30 performance from three that really were a big factor in ORU winning that game on Saturday afternoon, 103-86.
Well, a couple things come to mind, Tyler. Number one, going into this that weekend, we were first in our league in 3-point field goal percentage defense. And, you know, they hit some tough shots. But I also, you know, we needed to have a little bit better effort. And make them earn everything they get, you know. And it wasn't just Max. It was, like you said, the some guys that maybe haven't hit a bunch of threes on the year, you know, we had so much attention on Max and O'Banner that, you know, they were open and they made open shots. And, you know, they haven't necessarily done that this year, and they did, you know, on Saturday night. But and that's the way it goes. And then, you know, the second thing that comes to mind is, you know, we just, you know, we gave him, you know, everything that he could eat. You know, Max, you know, made 5 threes, you know, on Saturday, but he also made 10 free throws and, you know, made 6 or 7 2-point shots as well. Yeah. And so when you give him everything you can eat, he was a tough challenge for us that night.
The 18 turnovers were big, too, not just because of the turnovers, but ORU was able to get out and run and really capitalized in transition.
Well, we talked about it in the post game. You know, you got to make, you know, teams earn everything they get. And they had 24 points where, honestly, we felt like we didn't make them earn it. And, you know, some of that is off the turnovers. And you have to take care of the basketball and give yourself an opportunity to challenge those shots. And we didn't do a very good job of that on Saturday.
Well, then you go to Sunday, and a couple of things stand out about the difference in performances between the loss and then what turned out to be a 95-80 win on Sunday. First off, and we had talked about it going in, you were going to try to switch a little bit more and hope that aggressiveness would pay off. And there were a couple of times Asemus was able to get, let's say, a Douglas Wilson downhill and score at the rim. But more times than not, it neutralized their big men on the perimeter. And some of that comes back to the fact that when you have a Shireman switching or an Arian switching, it's unique to your program, but these are guys that guard ones and twos, and yet they are big enough, physical enough, and have experience guarding fours and fives that they can match up with post players as far as their defense is concerned.
Yeah, I mean, you know, we have some versatility in that sense.
Yes.
You know, our guys have experience of guarding multiple positions, and especially Baylor and Alex. You know, they're, you know, very, very versatile in that sense. And Doug, to a point, too, you know, his athleticism, we're able to do that because his athleticism putting him on Max, who, you know, had 42 on us the night before. Yeah. And so, you know, we have some versatility in that area. So that was big time. But you know, maybe more importantly, I thought, Tyler, was we had some connectivity on that defensive end. And we played together on that end of the floor as much as we did on the offensive end. And that's something that's really important for us. You know, sometimes, you know, it, the attention gets put on who's guarding the ball, you know, maybe who's involved in that ball screen, where in all honesty, it's those other guys that who's in your gaps, who's supposed to be tagging, how effective are they at slowing that part down, but then also recovering to take away, you know, that pass to their own guy. So that's where I thought maybe our energy level, our connectivities, we were connected on that defensive end on Sunday much better than we were on Saturday night.
Am I wrong in saying that this feels like this is becoming more and more Baylor Shireman's team? And I don't say that as a knock to a Wilson or anybody else on the roster. It just seems like Baylor's presence is felt more and more in a leadership role.
Well, two things. He really affects the game in many ways, which we've talked about a lot. But also he's becoming more vocal, you know. Yeah. and he's getting everybody in huddles. He's taking that leadership role upon himself, and we needed it. You know, we needed somebody with that, you know, eagerness to be vocal and bring this team together. And Baylor's doing that. But when you do that, you also have to produce.
Yes.
and he's doing that as well, and affect, like we talked about, affects the game in so many ways.
And again, speaking of producing, in every Summit League weekend, Douglas Wilson has scored double figures in both games. He's been over 20 in one of those two games. He had 23 on Sunday, and we joked about it that, boy, if he had that aggressiveness just a little bit more, what could he do? Because he turns it on, and when he does, there's nobody in this conference that can keep up with it.
Well, Doug and I, you know, talked on after the game on Saturday, and you know, I just didn't feel like he played with the energy that he normally does. And we talked about, hey, Doug, you need to wear yourself out 5 to 6 times a game where you say, Hendo, I need a breather, buddy, and we'll get you one. And we got guys that are ready to rock and roll on the bench, and it was pretty awesome to see him ask out of the game four times on Sunday because he was playing his tail off on both ends of the floor.
Talk about how valuable Shireman is, how valuable Wilson is. And I've said it time and again, I just don't think Arians gets enough credit from outsiders to what he means to this program. 15 points, 10 rebounds, 4 assists. And yet, like we joked, his consecutive free throw streak ended. That's probably what he was most feeling was the fact that he missed a couple of free throws. But he just does so many things for your basketball team.
When he's playing at a high level, our team is really, really good. He gives us that other weapon. He's very, very versatile, you know, as a 6'5 point guard that really is a pass first guy. It gets the ball moving right away. And when that happens, it's contagious. So we really, really share the basketball. Alex has always been a really, really good rebounder. And that's something that, you know, is huge for our team. If we can continue to win the rebounding battle, like we did on Sunday, and we won it by 20 rebounds, this team can be special. And it's going to be a huge part of this coming weekend, too.
Matt Dentlinger was an all-league performer a year ago, had been looking to be a consistent presence this year, had struggled in finding his consistency, but his last three games, he's been as consistent as he has all year.
Consistent in his physical, you know, and I think that's probably something that has been missing. And he's been so much more physical, so much more aggressive, running the floor great, and really doing a tremendous job defensively. And so it's been great to watch Matt continue to get better throughout the year. And you know, for three games in a row, I just feel like he's trending in a really, really good direction.
And what a testament to the depth of your offense, which we've talked about. You take an all-league performer out on Sunday, and yet you still have six other guys that score double figures, and you put up 95 points.
Yeah, you know, obviously – Noah didn't play on Sunday, and then we stuck Charlie into that starting lineup, and Charlie's gained a lot of confidence here in the last couple weeks. You know, obviously we've challenged him probably more on the defensive end than the offensive end, but you know what, he feels engaged, and he's so capable, and you know, he's hit some big shots for us, and obviously against USD 2 weeks ago, and then obviously again, you know, on Sunday. He's just, you know, he's playing with great energy and great confidence, and Luke coming off the bench, and David Winget, who started the majority of our games last year. I mean, those three guys in particular coming off the bench, and then Matty Mims, who had, you know, was a great, you know, bench player for us last year. So those four guys with that experience is really fantastic.
We'll talk more with SDSU men's coach Eric Henderson in just a moment as our Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show continues. We are live thanks to our friends at Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill. Stick around. You're listening to the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield IMG College.
Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill is your sports headquarters with more than 50 TVs providing the area's best sports viewing environment, including the NFL Sunday Ticket, ESPN College Extra, NHL Center Ice, and other sports packages. Plus daily food and drink specials. Open to all ages daily at 11 and Saturdays at 10. Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill, a Brookings original in downtown Brookings and a proud sponsor of the Jacks.
In South Dakota, farming is more than cornfields and combines. It's the small moments and big challenges we all face every day. It's getting up in the morning, taking care of what needs to be done, doing the best you can, and being thankful for the opportunity to do it again tomorrow. This is real. This is life. This is farming. To learn more about farming, visit thisisfarming.org. Brought to you by South Dakota Corn.
In the truck game, greatness is defined by a relentless commitment to the customer, forged over decades and built by a team resolute in helping you achieve your greatness. Experience the all-new 2021 Ford F-150 and Ford Super Duty for a performance like no other. Ford F-Series, America's best-selling truck for 44 years straight and counting, based on 1977 to 2020 calendar year total sales.
It's back, the return of the prestigious Learfield IMG College Directors' Cup, honoring college sports excellence across all competitive divisions, both men's and women's sports. Follow along with L Directors' Cup on Twitter or online to see which schools will be taking home a first-place trophy in June for their season-long success. Learfield IMG College Directors' Cup,
a premier institutional award jointly launched in 1993 by USA Today and NACTA.
Let's be real. You make things. You grow things. You do things. You want things. And that's where we come in. We're First Bank and Trust, a community bank that understands the unique needs of our community and the people who make it great. First Bank and Trust is just the right size to make big things possible while making sure the small things never feel that way. First Bank and Trust, real banking, real easy. Member FDIC, Equal Opportunity Lender.
Whether you're buying or selling your home, turn to the dedicated team of professionals at Century 21, Krogman & Company. Century 21 is a proud member of Jack's Home Team and is the preferred real estate partner of Jackrabbit Athletics. Check them out today at century21brookings.com. Or for more information on Jack's Home Team, visit gojacks.com/home team.
Time, Jaden? Okay.
Got 45 seconds, Endo.
Okay, buddy.
Yeah, I'm still here in case you guys blink out. Let me know. I'll get the screwdriver out.
Thank you, Rembler. Appreciate that.
100 points on your Royal Rewards card and receive your kitchen essential. First come, first serve. Collect all four. Royal River Casino Hotel. Must be 21.
What's different about LG Seeds? You get a team of real people focused on real results for your entire operation. While other companies say teamwork, LG Seeds lives it. From lab to field, we're there every step of the way to help you find your next advantage. Pair that with your drive, and it all comes down to this. Divide the tasks, multiply the results. Get down to business at lgseeds.com.
Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, the proud presenting sponsor of our Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show. I'm Tyler Merriam, along with the head coach of the men, joining us via phone in Joplin, Missouri, because of the travel issues the men's and women's basketball teams have had over the past few days. Eric Henderson is with us. And Coach, I know your phone's lit up. I've had a ton of people asking me about Noah Friedel. We talked about it a little. Didn't play in the second half on Saturday, and then you and he made the collective decision to not play on Sunday. So first and foremost, how is Noah Friedel right now?
Yeah, Noah's doing good. Noah's an awesome kid, and you know, it's been a long season for everybody. There's a lot that's, you know, going on with the COVID and all that sort of stuff. And so Noah and I decided to, you know, sit down and talk after Saturday's game. And we just came up with the, you know, conclusion together that it was best that, you know, he didn't play on Sunday night. So, yeah, but Noah's doing well.
Any chance we see Noah Friday, Saturday, or both in the games at Fargo against North Dakota State?
Yeah, that's a, you know, a day-to-day decision that, you know, Noah and I will continue to talk, and we'll always do what's best for Noah and the team.
Well, let's talk about this Bison team that you'll be seeing. You've seen NDSU in person once, beat them by two in a game that was very tight down the stretch. Of course, you're a different team. You didn't have Douglas Wilson in that game. They are a different team. In fact, Luke Apple played so well in the post offensively, they kind of reconsidered how they do things in the post defensively. So this is a Bison team that right at the top of the league with Cruiser and Grizzo down the line. What impresses you most about David Richmond's squad?
Yeah, well, obviously they're very talented, but what probably impresses me the most is they're really, really disciplined. You know, they don't take bad shots. They make you earn every basket that you get, and they rebound it at a high level. You know, they probably don't score it maybe as well as they have in the past with some really maybe just one dynamic player or two that where they get maybe the majority of their points, but they're very balanced and they can score at every single position. So they create a lot of challenges for us. And obviously, you know, we're tied for first in the league with them. And so there's a lot on the line, and it's always fun to play meaningful games in the middle end of February. And it sure seems like we've played many with the Bison. So we're looking forward to it again.
Get the sense too, at least I do, that the tempo is a big factor in both of these games, that NDSU wants to minimize the number of possessions to maximize how much they mean. And you're the inverse. You want to maximize the number of possessions that you have.
Yeah, it's a little bit of, you know, contrasting style. Yeah. So it'll be a fun, you know, to see who can get the advantage in that sense. You know, we try to, you know, push it up the floor at a really, really quick pace and try to, you know, get our post entries very, very early in the possession and play off of that where, you know, they're, you know, try to get the ball reversed, you know, and run some time and then maybe, you know, be a little bit more aggressive at the end of the shot clock. But they're opportunistic as well. They're not just trying to stall or slow the game up. You know, they just want to take really, really good shots. And it's not that we don't. We just try to get into our stuff maybe a little bit quicker. So that contrast in style will be interesting and to see who can get the edge.
There might not be a big man who can do all the different things Rocky Cruiser can do in this league. There are some big guys that can shoot it from the outside. There are some big guys that can score at the rim, but he can put it on the floor. They run a high point offense at times through him. He really presents a unique challenge for anybody's defense.
Yeah, no, his ability to stretch the floor and make threes is what really, you know, is probably key for him and their team. You know, they play him at the, you know, top of the key in their three low offense quite often and sets a lot of ball screens. So it makes a challenge. What do you want to do? Do you want to switch? Do you want to, you know, hedge and slow the point guard down or what, you know? So we'll have some decisions to make on that, but Rocky's ability to shoot really is where it starts. And then he certainly has the ability to score off the bounce. He's super athletic, very, very long, and can play with his back to the basket a little bit as well too. So his versatility and ability to stretch the floor certainly create challenges for any team, including ours.
Well, Hendo, we got to let you run. Be safe, get home safely, and we'll talk to you very soon, all right?
Always a pleasure, my friend, and we're looking forward to being home as well.
Eric Henderson, the head coach of the SDSU men. For Hendo and AJ, I'm Tyler Merriam. See you next time on the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield, IMG College.
On the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield, IMG College, the Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show has been brought to you by Sanford Health. Even in uncertain times, we're ready to see you. Sanford Health. Health lives here. Bud Light. Whenever there's a game to watch, there's a Bud Light there. Case IH. Step up your game with top-performing Case IH equipment. State Farm. When you want the real deal, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. First Bank and Trust. Because everyone should play hard and bank easy. South Dakota Corn. This is Farming. Proud sponsor of the South Dakota Showdown Series. First Premier Bank, Premier Bank Card. Believe in possibility. Member FDIC. Midco SN. This is how we do sports. Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, a Brookings original and your sports headquarters. And by Farm Credit Services of America. Call Farm Credit Services of America for your ag financing. Agriculture works here. The preceding has been a Learfield IMG College presentation of the Jackrabbit Sports Network.